The Eye of the World, Chapter 2, Strangers. The other members of the village council have arrived, and they begin to discuss the latest issues. Rand tries to overhear what is said, and notices that the blacksmith, Harold Luhan, is giving Matt a dark look. Matt drags Rand away, and explains that Master Luhan suspects him of a prank gone very wrong. He convinced the younger boys, Adan Alkar, Dag Coplin, and Erwin Fingar, that he'd seen ghost hounds. So he flowered the Luhan's dogs and released them. How was he to know that the dogs would run straight back home and get flour all over the house, causing Alsbet Lewin to throw the dogs and the blacksmith out? While the boys are bringing the casks into the inn cellar, they're greeted by the mayor's wife, Marin Alvia, who offers them honey cakes and cider. Rand feels easy with Mistress Alvia. She never tries to interfere and badger Tam about remarrying. The pair begin to discuss the gleeman until they're interrupted by a young boy, Erwin, talking about two strangers in Emmons Field, the Lady Moraine and her guard, Lan. Rand asks if the guard is wearing a black cloak. Erwin is confused, saying his cloak is green and grey, and it makes him seem invisible at times. The lady wears blue silks, unlike any feast day clothes he's ever seen. She's the most beautiful woman, and must be a high-born lady. Matt remembers that he meant to tell Rand about them before they got distracted about the Black Rider, explaining that they arrived last night. Their horses are extremely fine, tall and sleek. Erwin tells him that the Wisdom doesn't like the Lady Moraine because she called Nynaeve child. Rand and Matt whistle in shock as Erwin continues that she had apologised and asked the Wisdom questions about herbs and the villagers, but Nynaeve is not happy. When Sen called her a child last year, she thumped him with her stick. Erwin asks Rand if there really is a gleeman. He doesn't trust Matt after all of his pranks. When they finish unloading, the council is in full session, so the boys leave the inn, finding Bella and the cart stabled away. Rand felt a sense of being watched and spots a raven staring at him from the inn roof. He curses as Matt also claims to be sick of being watched. They both grab stones and throw them at the bird, which simply steps aside and continues to glare at the boys. A vile bird, a woman's voice says from behind them, to be mistrusted at the best of times. The raven launched off crying shrilly, flying into the distance. Rand turns to the woman and is shocked by how short she is, considering she'd called Nynaeve a child. But he couldn't put an age to her. Her long ringlets of dark brown hair, a blue stone on a chain at her forehead, and a golden serpent ring on her finger. They introduce themselves to her, and Moraine insists that they don't call her lady. She tells them she may have tasks that need doing, and could she count on them to help? They agree eagerly, and she presses a coin into each boy's hand as payment. Rand sees that his coin is a silver mark with the face of an unknown woman, and notes its worth of a good horse in shock. Rand asks why Moraine is here in Emmonsfield. She reveals she's a historian, and there are many old stories to be found here. The boys scoff at anything of worth ever happening in the Two Rivers. Moraine just smiles and walks away, and a man Rand hadn't seen steps up to her, wearing a cloak that seems to change colours, his dark hair held up in a top knot and a leather cord around his head. Erwin points him out as being Lan and speculates if he's a warder, which Matt ridicules. Everyone knows that warders wear gold and bejeweled armour and fight trollocs at the Blight. Rand and Matt discover their coins are identical, while Erwin's is a simple silver penny, and they all vow not to spend their coins. Loud shouts from further down the village draw their attention to the peddler's wagon riding over the wagon bridge. Rand thinks that now the fireworks arrived, a gleeman and the new strangers, it was going to be the best bell time ever.